All right. I still don't completely have my voice back, but I figured that it would be fun to play The Age of Decadence, mainly because I tried to install Metro Exodus and it wouldn't work. So, getting back to a slow-paced game. You know, they said that combat was rough in this game, but I totally underestimated how bad it really was. Like, my ass fucked. Okay, see, this is where I went wrong last time. Let's load the game. I was wondering whether Darathon the Legatus Legionis Tiberius Catalyst, our great ancestor, had shown the world the true meaning of courage. With less than a full legion, he faced 20,000 men and stood his ground. He could have retreated and waited for reinforcements, but cowards never accomplish anything. Catalyst saw an opportunity and he took it. After the battle, the emperor himself named Catalyst the Dux Padar, calling him the Dux Pillar, the Dux Amal, the highest honor. Only a few hundred men survived the battle. Instead of disbanding them, the Emperor ordered them to rebuild the Legion and gave it well. Horrible. Alright. Did I already, like, lose my money or no? Let's see. The world map. Is that where I'm supposed to go? Is modern? No, bro, this seems rough.
Now, what if... what if I just put all my points in sneak? Let's see. That was right, right? Yeah, there we go. 6 in sneak. Okay, so here's the camp. Oh, fuck. Alright, you recognize some machines from the drawings. It looks like an ore melting facility, but judging by how Sorelli is, damn it, come on. Ooh. Yeah. Jeez. Damn. Oops. and said, look for him in the market square. It's like Asmodeus or something. Friend, thanks to your generosity, my family is safe. It seems that there's a good demand for bronze armor. I've got several orders, but repaying my debt to you comes first. Please accept this humble gift, the armor of my people. May it keep you safe. My gratitude, Amulius. So, what happened to your people? Raiders, it's getting really bad out there. The wasteland breeds its scum faster than ever before. 10 years ago, we were able to fend for ourselves. Last year, we spent more time fighting off raiders than farming. Just can't survive on your own anymore. So there's nothing left. There are a few places here and there. If they are well defended, they have a chance. But for how long? Once raiders come, you start losing men, and then it's only a matter of time. You need something to keep the raiders away. We'll keep them away. I have a place called Inferay, aptly named. In the old days, the word meant sacrifice other to the souls of the dead heroes. They say the village is built around a pit which connects itself to good friend. Good man. Damn, 176, that must be really good. Okay. Shanty town. Okay, so I'm looking for a man named Raskos. How you've been trading with Aurelians down at the mine. What'd you do? Your House Duretan is about to reclaim the mine, so your business venture is done one way or another. You can still make a few coins, so what do I have to do? Spike the mine. No way I'm not getting it home. Which do you want? 100 Imperials. I don't need him to spike the line. Let's see if I can go tell my boy that he needs 100 Imperials and maybe that guy will give me some money. Goddamn, took my boy a long time to get here. No, to tell. I was young and good with a sword. I took a job guarding caravans, you know? See the world, kill a few men, make a few coins, a romance of the wasteland. Turned out it was just another shit job for shit pay. I worked it for 3 years and then decided maybe time to switch sides, just like that. Nothing happens just like that. You ever worked caravans? Good men are expensive, so the merchant guilds hire what comes cheap, kids. Rejects, cutthroats, they start dropping like flies after an attack or two, which means less sleep, more shit to deal with. I also thought about going back to the mines. I believe one comes with the other. It's the other that I'm not looking forward to. There are three ways to make a living. If you're good with a sword, you can do it for nothing. Guarding caravans or fighting for the Imperials. You can do it for yourself. Sooner or later, you'll piss someone off and swat you like a fly. Oh, nice. I suppose I can spare a minute. Thanks. Sweet. Pretty epic, thanks, bro. She can't help but notice her ring. Stones like this are bound to fetch a good price. Responds to blaming hasty craftsmanship to the pure blood of the spirits who died there during the war. Abandoned their dinner, rotting human remains and disappeared inside one of the scores.
Yeah. Not only this side works. Do you think I
want to
see that?
I need to see myself in it. That hurts my eyes.
It magnifies it like 20 times.
I mean, you could still clean that other side off.
You're supposed to replace them like every like 10 years. Like these were $3,000. Like I don't want to replace them every 10 years.
Yeah. Okay. That's not too bad though. You can fix that.
This?
Yeah.
I Have you tried pulling this off?
You just gotta wipe it off with, like, alcohol.
What?
Have a dollar. That's it.
Have $2 you want?
No, I don't need it.
You want something at work? Come on.
Damn, they all have blades. It's scary. See if I can still need my lock picking skill to go up. Trying to decide how to find this fucking dude that he was talking about. I don't want to kill him. But I mean, shit, if he gets me some money, I might
Vincent, now fuck off.
Alright, let's see. Where's Fing? What's got a Fing? Cassius, what's up? Forty-two-year Lord Master Cassius contemptuously called young Cassius by his grey-haired colleagues, but understood the appeal of the to instead of him. You to Master Cassius, who is personally guest of Lord Matthias. Master Fing asked me to kill him, but as soon as I learned, yeah, he thought the Lord Matthias would pay you more to keep Cassius alive. He knew in sight, which has been used. Ah, oh, fuck. I speak to Lord Matthias. Make more money or no? I guess I didn't even do it for the money, goddammit. Can I hunt these rats now, or is that, like, off the table? Helicopter. What can I do for you? I need a job. I've seen you around, but I've never heard of you. Business is slow, I can't afford to give jobs, so may or may not have what it takes. If you're serious about trying the Imperial Guards, they hire all kinds. You son of a bitch. Put the master near the earth. Same thing, I guess. Put the master near the earth. Okay. I get it. I'm not wanted here. Oh, did I get paid more though? I didn't see. I did not get paid at all. Guess I should go see Fing, huh? Alright. I have to assume that that's all I can do. Let me just make sure, maybe. Oh yeah, they're all gone. Shit. Shit, that is an accurate depiction of what it's like whenever you're trying to... Damn. Let me just exit and save. Taking the demise of the Imperial Guards at the hands of the boatmen as a good omen, Lord Antias steps up to the Queen of Arms, Drought, and pardons our granted to bandits and raiders willing to serve the House of Mercenaries, hard and mess. But Imperial Guards to keep the newly aided fighting men in check, the town quickly descends into near lawlessness, a little more than a camp mercenary army. Waiting for order, though Antias seems to hold the reins of the Sellsword Legion, it is the Comercium who pays their wages, and the only loyalty mercenary truly recognizes is the one who pays them. By becoming the paymaster for the entire Legion, the Comercium effectively becomes Antidius' shadow partner, clearly expanding their influence and control over the local trade. Backed by the Legion, the Comercium's influence grows alongside their control over the local trade board and seeking entertainment, the camp mercenaries. Establishment almost as quickly as they earn them, making a very profitable enterprise indeed. Double crossing to help Cassius to replace him. If you turn Genazar, should you ever end up in Genazar, you would be worse if you were there. I mean, I'm not part of his, like, religion, but okay. Epic. After weeks of travel, Matarin's marble minarets and sandstone domes finally appear in the shimmering desert. Once the jewel of the empire, it is now a city crumbling ruins. And forgotten glory, the river that fed it dry. Its once fertile fields now barren rock and endless drifting sand. Great war devastated Matarin. Almost a quarter of its citizens died in the arcane blast that created the infamous abyss. The sickness that followed it nearly succeeded in wiping out the rest, but cities rarely die with dignity. Man returned to Matarin. Scavengers seeking to loot the treasures of the past, oblivious to the weight of history around them as they squabbled over food and gold. Sounds shitty. Clericus. You're too late. This is a mad setting next to an empty stall when you approach it. Get vandals after it'll take weeks to the next one to pop. You can tell me about Genazar. It is a lovely town. It's built in cascading hills and mountains. Come side, my friend. Kim Nebby. What's up, Kim Nebby?
What do you want?
It's 50.
I kinda don't talk to people, I don't know.
Cool. Kim Nebby sucks, that's fine. Alright. What's a good place to save? I'm gonna save and quit here. Oh wait, let me go back to... This is the drinking establishment.
What can I do for you? I suppose I'm about it. The establishment.
I'm balding my own around pudgy face and bags of ears.
Nothing.
I can't sit and drink. I mean, damn. Seems like business is rough. Yeah.